The temperatures are starting to drop, and we're seeing more and more rain, which means that we're nearing the end of the wildfire season. This year's fire season started a little early and was heavily affected by the devastating winter we had in December and January. Meteorologist Paul Beam talked with the Bureau of Land Management to see how bad the season was and if we're in the clear moving forward.
With fall here and firmly in place, we look back at the scarring that this fire season has caused. Land that was once covered in sagebrush is now charred with the dark husks of former plant life. After a winter of heavy snow, the moisture allowed plants and grass to have a bountiful growing season, which unfortunately led to a strong start to the season.
Back in, you know, May, June, we were kind of looking at it. This could be really bad. This season could go really long when we have those types of fuel loading. And we definitely did see we got started early back in right in the beginning of June.
And the fire season started here, just outside of Pocatello, where the Gap Fire was started. And all summer long, the fire season has steadily been rolling along.
From that Gap Fire, we were rolling really this fire season. It was a very steady, just kept going, and we still had our kind of average 50-50 for human-caused, lightning-caused fires.
Most of the human-caused fires were up in the Manan Butte area, which got hit particularly bad this year. Some of the causes included exploding targets, bullets, vehicles, and fireworks, which also was a severe problem in town
there,
this year.
We
but taking the whole season into account, we were right within the expected range of fires.
So we just asked
even though
people,
nationally it has been
know,
a difficult year, with the Forest Service's budget already being over $2 billion. Reporting in Pocatello, I'm Paul Beam, KBVI News that works for you.
Now the BLM wants to remind people that just because it's wetter and it's colder doesn't mean fires can't start, so continue to be vigilant.